हॅलो स्टुडंट्स, माय सेल्फ सिद्धेश्वर बी तुळजापुरे, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, वालचंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, सोलापूर. सो इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी फ्लो थ्रू पाईप्स इन पॅरलल. द लर्निंग आउटकम: ॲट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टुडंट्स विल बी एबल टू कॅल्क्युलेट डिस्चार्ज थ्रू ब्रँचड पाईप्स. These are nothing but these are pipes in parallel we are having. The contents are, firstly, the definition of pipes in parallel. Then we'll go for discharge through branched pipes. Then head loss in parallel pipes. Then numerical on flow through parallel pipes. And lastly, the references. That is flow through pipes in parallel. If main pipe gets divided into two or more branches and again joined together downstream to form a single pipe, then the branch pipes are said to be connected in parallel. Means see what? We are having, firstly, the pipe gets divided into two or more branches. That is one. And again, joined together downstream to form a single pipe. Means again they are joining. Means starting from one, then branching, then again the branches, they are meeting each other and we are having again the single pipe. So if this situation is there, then those branch pipes, these are called as, these are connected as, say, parallel, like that we are having. Now let us go for simplicity purpose only for two branches it is. Firstly, on the left hand side, you can observe the main pipe we are having. Then, so it is branched into two. So we are having one on the lower side and one on the upper side. So branch pipe number one, say on the lower side, branch pipe number two on the upper side. Again, they are meeting each other and we are having again the main pipe continuing. So in case of this, so in the diagram, you can observe here. So if suppose the discharge, it is Q, say through the main pipe, so this discharge will get divided into two. Say through the branch pipe number one, discharge is Q1. Through the branch pipe number two, discharge is Q2. And we are having the, say, parameters with reference to the branch pipe number one as L1, D1 and V1. These are corresponding to the length, diameter and velocity of flow. Then for branch pipe number two, it is L2, D2 and it is V2. So again, the Q1 and Q2, they are going to meet each other and again we are having, say, total discharge as Q as in the earlier case. Now, discharge through parallel pipes that we have discussed just now, but now we have taken only two branches. Instead of that one, suppose if you are having number of branches, that total Q, it will be equal to, so it is Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 plus dash dash, whatever number of those branched pipes are there. So those we have to write here. So through discharge through those pipes we are going to have on the right hand side. And say main pipe which was say before branching, so the discharge through that one will come on the left hand side. Now the notations used, these are, say L is equal to, it is length of pipe, D is equal to diameter of pipe, F is equal to coefficient of pipe, say V is equal to, it is velocity of flow, and then say we are having that say suffix 1 to represent the branch pipe, it is say branch pipe number, say for the say before the branching the pipe was only one, but two branches if you are considering, suffixes will be 1 and 2. Say F, it corresponds to the coefficient of pipe, that coefficient of friction it is actually. Now think of, say, whether the pipes in different branches can be of different materials. See the question is much clear. So it is earlier, suppose we are having one, say, MS pipe. Then suppose it is, say, branched into two and we are now interested in choosing the material for these two. And now, say, if whether, say, different materials can be there for, say, these two branches, like that the question is. Think of the same. See, the answer is yes. In case of these branched pipes, we can have the materials as different one. So you may choose the MS, you may choose the, say, other metallic materials for these, or even you may go for the concrete and other things, etc. So what matters is the coefficient of friction, etc., the diameter of that one. So these are going to matter, but so nowhere that condition is there for the pipes in parallel that the material should be same. So the pipes, say, which are used in the branches, these may be of different materials. Now let us consider the head loss. So head loss in parallel pipes we are having. So loss of head in branch pipe number 1 is equal to the loss of head in the branch pipe number, it is 2. So on the left hand side, we have written the formula for the loss of head in branch number 1. It is 4 F1 L1 V1 square by 2G D1. And for the right hand side, we are having this as, so it is 4 F2 L2 V2 square by 2G D2. So if suppose F1 is equal to F2, so in case of that one, we are having these as, so cancellation of common terms as 4, then 2G, 2G will be there along with this F1, F2. And say the equation will get reduced to L1 V1 square by 2G D1 is equal to L2 V2 square by, it is 2G D2. Now let us consider the numerical, say, for this one. And what we have observed is, for the parallel pipes, the head loss, it is going to remain same. So 4 FL V square by 2 GD of, say, branch number 1 is equal to 4 FL V square by 2 GD of branch number 2. And similarly, say, we will go for other branches if these are there. So now, in case of the present numerical, the data just I have listed down. So it is length of parallel pipes is suppose equal to 2000 meters. Then coefficient of friction of two pipes is suppose 0.005. Then diameter of first pipe is equal to 1 meter. Diameter of second pipe is, say, lesser than the first one, so it is 0.8 meters. And if the total flow is 3 meter cube per second, say, what is flow rate through the pipe number 1 and 2? So that is the question. We'll move to the solution. In case of these parallel pipes, we are having the head loss as same in all branches. Say head loss in first branch, it is equal to the head loss in the second branch. So 4 F1 L1 V1 square by 2G D1 is equal to, say, it is 4 F2 L2 V2 square by, it is 2G D2. So again, have the cancellation of the terms as much as possible so that the calculations will get reduced and you will get the, say, answer in the few steps and simple steps it is. In the present case, the coefficient of friction of the branch number 1 and branch number 2, they have given same. So it is F1 is equal to F2 is equal to, we are having some value as 0.005. So presently not required for this step. So L1, L2, these are same. So these are corresponding to the, say, length of the pipes. So length of pipe, it is, say, 2000 meters. So L1 is equal to L2 we are having. And say the common terms, if you cancel out 2G, 4, etc. So along with F, only L1, L2 is also getting cancelled. Only velocity is remaining in the numerator. So V1 square, V2 square on the right hand side. And here it is D1 and here it is D2. So V1 square by D1 is equal to, it is V2 square by D2 we are having. So putting the value of, say, D1 and D2, so these are 1 meter and 0.8 meters. So V1 square by 1 is equal to V2 square by 0.8. It will be equation number 1. Then from continuity equation, we can have this one as A1 is equal to, it is A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Say A1, it is pi by 4 D1 square into V1. So is equal to A2, it is pi by 4 D2 square into, it is V2. So cancellation of pi by 4 will be there, and D1 square V1 is equal to, it is D2 square V2 we are having. So in this case, what you can do is, you can put again the values of D1 and D2 and see what you get. So D1 is equal to, it is 1, say, square of 1, so into, it is V1. So is equal to, so it is D2 square we are having, so it is 0.8 bracket square into, it is V2. So this is equation number 2. So equation number one, so it is between v1 and v2 we are having. That is two parameters we are having which are unknown. So it is v1, v2. Equation two, it is also containing v1, v2. So the case is two equations and two unknowns we are having. So we can put the value of either v1 in terms of v2 or v2 in terms of v1. So if you solve these two equations, you will get the value of v2 as 2.17 meters per second, v1 as 2.427 meters per second. Then you can go for the discharge through the branch number 1. So it is q1 is equal to, it is a1 v1. So it is pi by 4 d1 square into v1 you will have. So it comes out to be 1.906 meter cube per second. Then similarly, we will get the value of q2 as equal to, it is a2 v2 you can do. And you will get this value as 1.094 meter cube per second. Later on, just you can have one check by adding values of q1 and q2, whether you are getting the value as 3 or not. So that you can check. So 3, it is the discharge through the main pipe. So here you can observe, so the total summation, it is equal to, say, total discharge is 3 meter cube per second. So this will ensure that, say, that you have not gone wrong anywhere. So apart from this, if you observe that, say, value of coefficient of friction, etc., these are given, but say these are getting cancelled as these are same. L1, L2 also, these are given, but these are getting cancelled. These are the references which are used for this particular session. Thank you.